Honeybees are a domesticated animal. One of the big things that the news stories leave you with is that they're all going to die, or they're in danger of dying. Well, the honeybee is never going to disappear. It is the least threatened pollinator on the planet. My whole point is, what is the new honeybee going to look like?
We're trying to come up with a new line of bees using Africanized bees as our main stock. Although they have really bad characteristics such as, you know, defensiveness, aggression, which, you know, kills lots of people, dogs, and other animals, but they have really good characteristics. And the main one is they are really tolerant to diseases and pests, especially the main one, the varroa mite.
The Africanized bees right now, I call them the coyotes of the bee world, because nobody wants them, but they continue to thrive.
Wouldn't it be great if we could take some of that genetic resistance of Africanized bees and reduce a little bit of the aggression so that we have a good enough bee that you could work, that you could put in a farm, that is going to be manageable, resistant, and prolific. We want to try to harness that, but to do it right, you have to know what's in them. So we're combining our field experiments with the actual bees and going through what a beekeeper would normally have to go through, and then kind of fact-checking through the molecular aspects of those bees.
The goal is to increase the number of European genes in to make a workable bee that we can use in agriculture to replace the one that we currently have because it's susceptible. Honeybees are from the old world. North America, Central America, and South America had no honeybees until they were brought here by man. People don't realize that. They think that honeybees have always been here. They're part of our environment. They're needed for the pollination of all our native plants, and it's simply not true. You have to break it into two different areas. You have ecology and agriculture. So they can be an ecological nightmare, but an agricultural salvation. What humans use them for is to pollinate crops.
We need healthier bees, solitary and managed healthier bees, and we need to work on the way we farm. We need to work on the way we provide them with nutrition. What we call fallow land can be put to use. I think hopefully leads to a better integration of agriculture and conservation of natural resources.